Hi everyone, my name is Esther and this is the last part of the eeny, meeny, tiny little series about speaking. Before we start, as always, please read your word, but also speak your word and your life will never be the same. Okay, I've discussed a lot of things in this mini, tiny series. And today I want to discuss with you, this is the last part, I want to discuss with you, how do you deal with people in your environment who are speaking death in your life? And what I always do when people, most of the time people will say during flu season, most of the time in October or November, they will say, oh, watch out for the flu. Or when people are having a cold, they will say, oh, please do not come near me, otherwise you will get infected or something like that. And how I handle this, I will always say, the flu, I will not get the flu because I believe in Jesus Christ. And when people are not believing in Jesus and don't want to hear about Jesus, I will say, for an instance on my job or when you are outside somewhere, I will always say, well, flu, I'm not afraid for the flu. The flu needs to be afraid of me. I'm not fearful of any flu. And then I will always try to say that I believe in Jesus Christ. And because of him, it is that I will not receive the flu. And but people will speak to you all kinds of horrible things. And I will always try to renounce it, or I will try to say the opposite. But if the conversation is still going south and it is not a ministry conversation or people are just nagging and complaining, I will walk out. I will walk by and say, well, have a nice day. I will not be participating to this conversation anymore. That's the choice I've made because I do not want to have death seeds in my life. And also I've heard also a lot of people will say, well, we just get old and do you see the wrinkles and maybe you need Botox. And I will always say, Botox? Getting old? I will say no. I strongly believe in Psalm 103 verse 5, because you satisfy my mouth with good and you renew my youth as the eagles. And that's what I'm explaining. It's my anti-wrinkle cream I will use. Or I will use Deuteronomy 34 verse 7. And I will, the verse says, and Moses was 120 years old when he died. His eye was not dim or natural force abated. And I will always say, well, I will die at a good old age. And my eyesight will not be dim, nor my natural force abated. And I will say it all day. I will say it every day. I also speak Deuteronomy 28, all the blessings. Not the curses, but all the blessings. And it's so important for you and for me to speak the correct words. And I've given you a few examples on how to deal with it and how to speak the word. But I also speak the word of the private promises that God did to me, in particularly in my life. And when God is saying, is telling me promises, I always ask, oh Lord, thank you so much for this promise. Can you also please give me a scripture with it? And then he will give me a scripture and I will speak the scripture. I will eat the scripture. I will meditate on the scripture. I will start the day with the scripture and I will end the day with that scripture because I want this promise and I will speak this promise until I see it come to pass because I believe what he says is always true. He is not a liar, it is always true. So that you can do the same. You can ask him for what are your private promises, your promises that he has for your life. Because my life is not the same as your life, and your life is not the same as mine. Maybe you need millions of dollars or money, and I'm in need of something else. But we have private promises, and these private promises, please keep on speaking them and do not curse it. but only speak to correcting. So I hope this mini-series has helped you a little bit and that it has blessed you. And please, from my heart, speak. Not speaking only positive things are good, but speak the word and your life will never be the same. Okay, see you at the next series. Bye.